Hello friends, greetings from R&R Education. If you are new to the channel, click the subscription button and press the bell icon to stay updated on the new content from R&R Education. In this video, we shall discuss few points about the privatization of Indian Railways. As we all know, the Indian government has given green signal to the privatization of Indian Railways, and Piyush Goyal has led Indian Railways to take the important step for this mega private train project. With over 109 pairs of routes being identified for the introduction of 151 private trains across India, Indian Railways will choose private entities through a two-stage competitive bidding process, request for qualification and request for proposal. RFQ process will be for pre-qualification and shortlisting of bidders based on their technical and financial capacity, who will be required to offer a fixed price bid at RFP stage for undertaking the project, and the entire process will take up to 6 months. This mega private train project is estimated to attract an investment of ₹30,000 crores. Here, Indian Railways have identified 109 routes, of which it has divided into 12 clusters. The list of clusters has been shown. Here, the Mumbai has been divided into two clusters, Mumbai 1 and 2, as well as Delhi has been divided into two clusters, that is Delhi 1 and 2. So, the remaining clusters are Chandigarh, Howrah, Patna, Prayagraj, Secunderabad, Jaipur, Chennai and Bengaluru. Coming to the capability of private trains, here each private train will have a minimum of 16 coaches and have a capability of attaining 160 km per hour speed, which is faster than the fastest train of the Indian Railways operating until now. Coming to benefits of privatization of Indian Railways, passengers can certainly look forward to travel faster, more comfortable and can experience a world-class travel. These trains will be manufactured by the private sector in India by initiative Make in India. This also will create a huge boost in job creation. Private entities are going to be responsible for financing, procuring, operation and maintenance. For safety of a passenger, modern GPS enabled announcement system which enables onboard announcements for station arrivals, time to next station or destination, and the safety announcements are also included. Last year, Indian Railways commissioned IRCTC to run private trains on its routes, after which IRCTC launched Tejas Express. The first Tejas Express was inaugurated on 24 May 2017, which runs between Mumbai to Goa. The second Tejas Express was inaugurated on 1st March 2019 and was flagged off by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. This train runs between Chennai to Madurai Junction. The train is designed to run at a maximum speed of 200 km per hour. But the maximum operating speed allowed is 130 km per hour due to track and safety constraints. That's it for today. Please give this video a thumbs up. If you want to see more videos like this in future, hit the subscribe button. And lastly, if you have any other ideas or any other topics you want me to cover in the future, leave a comment below. That's all I have it for today. Hope you enjoyed and hope you see you next time.